Well, here he is, the smartest of the Walters brothers, the best looking of the Walters brothers. Kerrod, welcome to The Fan.
Pleasure to be in the show, but I'm actually a big fan of The Fan.
Oh, you're a good man, and they're all true statements. Smartest, best looking.
Well, goes with the same.
We find ourselves today, we love the fold-out chair, we come to you, we hear your story post-football. This is Shop 9 Menswear at Cotton Tree in Queensland. You find yourself in this business. Was this always part of the life plan?
It certainly wasn't. No, obviously I had a bit of an interest in fashion, but never envisioned myself being in my own shop at age 51 or 52. But I'm enjoying it. It's a good change, and it's a challenge. Yeah.
What are people like when they do come in and they discover this store? And hang on, you're
they sort of have a bit of a faint look at me, and they walk around, and then they see the photo, and they put two and two together. And then we start having a chat about footy, and it goes on from there.
The Kerrod Walters story. It's hard not to tell your story without mentioning Steve and Kevin. It's an incredible feat to have three brothers achieve such wonderful success in this great sport.
Yeah, it's something we sort of didn't really sort of think anything about until after it all happened, and now we're retired, you can sort of reflect on what we did, and for three of us to play Origin and to play for Australia, you know, it was a big achievement, and something that Mum and Dad were very proud of. Unfortunately, they're no longer with us, but yeah, it's something that we can always sort of cherish at time. We were good enough to play for our country and our state, and unfortunately, Steve and I played the same position, so yeah, we didn't get to play as much Origin as we would have liked, but that's footy.
You were on deck at the Broncos right from the get-go, not necessarily in the starting side game one, but in a short space of time, you've taken the spot of Greg Kinescu, and you're off on your ride. It must feel special to have been there right from day one at the Brisbane Broncos.
Yeah, it certainly was a great time to be part of the Broncos. I mean, obviously the initial year was exciting times for Brisbane. It did take away from the local league, but I think it was a great evolution for the game. And the Broncos are the Broncos today because of what those guys in 1988 did and how they, you know, paved the way for such a great, you know, tradition and such a great club.
Part of those first two premierships, we've spoken to others that were part of 92. A day that you always look back on as one of the great days of your footballing life, perhaps a great day of your life, full stop.
Yeah, obviously, it's everyone's dream to win a grand final. Obviously, you talk to people that have played for the country and played Origin, but they really want to win a grand final, and there's been a lot of great players that haven't achieved that feat. So for us to do it and to do the first one for Brisbane, it was great times, and we didn't really appreciate what it meant to our supporters until we got back to Brisbane.
To win back-to-back, it's something that's so rare. Is there a secret to that?
Oh, we had a pretty good footy team. Obviously, the salary cap wasn't as stringent as it is now, and you know, the comp's just so even. You know, the salary cap has certainly, you know, done what it's supposed to do, and that's even the comp out, because now you've got 16 teams and there's not much between them. Whereas, you know, back in our day, you know, there was a fair bit between the bottom teams and the top teams.
Representing Queensland and Australia, it should go without saying Australia is the greatest honour, but then Queensland's like a country of its own.
Well,
the first time you represent Queensland, is that about as good as it gets?
Well, when you grow up as a young kid in Ipswich, you know, you just want to play for your country, because that was all about watching the Kangaroo Tours and watching those great players of years gone by, you know, put on the Australian jersey, and that was certainly a goal of ours. But then Origin became its own beast in 1980, and then we were at that first game in 1980 watching from the side, watching from the outer, and we just thought, how good is this? We want to play Origin, and that's how then we had the passion for Origin as well. So. But yeah, it's just a privilege to both play for your country, and obviously it's an honour to play for Queensland.
The twins, you know, they have a bit of that intuition. Were you always on the same page with everything with Kevy?
Oh yeah, we just because we've spent so much time together, we just sort of knew what each other and what we were all about, and particularly on the footy field, we knew what he was doing and what I was doing. So, and obviously Alf was pretty much a part of it as well. And the Ipswich connection was what they used to call us, but I think it was just the fact that we loved the game of footy and we just played like we're playing in the backyard, and we just threw the ball and we threw caution to the wind.
Beautiful. Not every football career can go according to plan. Along the way, you end up in Adelaide. The 2 years of the Adelaide Rams, how do you look back on that time?
Yeah, well, obviously, it was disappointing to leave the Broncos, but I just... it was time to leave, and the Adelaide Rams presented another, you know, really good... thing to do. It was a new team in Adelaide, and it was a challenge, and I was got to captain the team, and I really feel that Adelaide, had they stayed in the competition, could have been a force like the Melbourne Storm are now. There was plenty of support there for a team that was, you know, not a team full of superstars, just a team of battlers, and I think it's a shame that Adelaide actually not there anymore.
You know, when they run highlight reels of great Adelaide Rams moments, yes. Your post-try celebration. often appears in clips. Chicken dance?
The chicken dance.
Spur
yeah.
of the moment?
Just try and entertain the fans. It's about,
yes, you'll.
It's about giving the fans, you know, what they came to see, some entertainment and value for money. But it was just during a time with the Super League teams, the English teams used to layer up after they scored tries and the post-try celebrations. So I thought I'd give them a bit of their own medicine.
Yours was a chicken dance?
Chicken dance, yeah. I don't know how I came up with it, but I just did it. And, it's got a bit of publicity.
Now, Kerrod, away from football, the menswear store, that is now, between end of football and this business, pretty rough period in your life. Great shock. You actually had a heart attack.
I did, yeah. So it came as a shock to a lot of my teammates as well, knowing that, you know, I was one of the fitter guys in the team and tend to look after myself a bit better. But it's just one of those things where it happens. It's not, you know, it's heart disease isn't a thing that's just a happens to older people. I was, I think, 45 at the time, so but I try to get my message across to everyone that if there's anything that you find different to norm, go and see your doctor, because it could be the beginnings of a heart attack, because it's our biggest killer.
All right, my last one's a little bit different. I always like to throw a question out of left field. Is there something you'd like to say to your brothers that you've never said?
What can I say to them? Not really, no.
No.
For Kevy, I think, you know, from a bloke with probably limited ability, a bit of a swerve and a bit of a thing like that, to win six premierships and have something successful, he's done pretty well.
Probably not much you can tell him.
Yeah. And I thought Orson Singh was overrated as well, so Boxhead really. he got an opportunity to play Origin because I got suspended. You know, so
there we go.
So they were very lucky, really.
All right, I'll finish this way then. Plan B. Finish with the question. You're now successful off the field. You've been through a heart attack. Beautiful wife, Desley. She's a successful businesswoman. With all of those things, could you imagine your life without rugby league?
No, it was an amazing time. And it's funny you should say about, obviously, players that play rugby league. When you finish playing rugby league, a lot of players struggle with giving it up and having such a big void in their life. So I struggled for a number of years trying to think, what am I going to do now? And a lot of players I've seen have struggled. And so I think what gets you through is your mates that you have through playing footy that sort of are there for a phone call and a chat to get you back on your feet and to make sure that things are all right.
All right, and the fans can still come and meet you face-to-face. You're not here 7 days a week, but Shop 9 Menswear at Cotton Tree, they will find you behind the counter.
You will
fit them head to toe. Thank you, Kerrod. Kerrod Walters on the fan, the smartest and the best-looking of the Walters brothers.
Thank you.